Millions of refugees fleeing Ukraine since Russia invaded. Thousands being killed, soldiers on both sides of the conflict, but also civilians, women and children. Stories of trauma, as far as the eye can see. Hi, I'm Dr. Stan Steindl. I've just finished mowing my backyard for the day. Which was nice. It's sort of, well, really a privilege in this day and age to do something so simple. But of course, while I was doing the mowing, I was listening as well to reports coming from Ukraine. And so I thought I'd just have a look online and see what we can find about the crisis really that's unfolding there, the suffering that people are experiencing. 3,328,692 refugees have left Ukraine. And that was updated on the 19th of March, 2022. And I can only assume that more and more people are having to flee Ukraine every day. And out of that number, over 2 million refugees have made their way to Poland. Thank you, Poland, and Romania, Moldova, Hungary, Slovakia, all taking refugees. Some have even fled to Russia and to Belarus. Over 3 million refugees have left Ukraine. That's a larger population than most cities of the world. Even the biggest cities, Chicago, has fewer people than have had to flee Ukraine. That really is an enormous amount of suffering. I can't even imagine what that would be like to flee one's home with just the clothes on your back. And specific stories. A Ukrainian six-year-old who arrived in Poland described his five-day journey to the border as bombs, bombs, bombs. 6 years old and all of that trauma. As a clinical psychologist, my heart aches for the effect that that will have on this young person's life. And in actual fact, tens of thousands of asylum seekers continue to leave Ukraine each day. Now, of course, this is largely women, children, and elderly people, because men between the ages of 18 and 60 have to stay and fight. And there are estimates, too, of 6.5 million people displaced within Ukraine itself, losing their homes, still having to flee, just not yet crossing the border. And yet Russia continue this bloody war, closing in, although some reports suggest that they're not closing in as much as they might like. So they've shifted to launching missiles, indiscriminately it seems, attacking hospitals, kindergartens, theatres, and so on. Russian airstrikes ripped apart a theatre in Mariupol that served as a makeshift shelter for hundreds of people, Ukrainian officials said on Thursday. Apparently the theatre had written on the outside, "Children." And yet, it was still bombed. And of course, there are airstrikes dotted about the country. But as I was mowing the yard, I was thinking about another important part of compassion, really, is something around generosity. If we think of our evolved species, we evolved early on to care and share. In other words, we looked after each other, cared for each other, and shared resources for the greater good. We shifted, of course, to something of a hold and control strategy with the advent of agriculture and the importance of owning land and so on. But compassion really arises from a wellspring of generosity. That willingness to give or share. And really, there's no better example of this than how many of those refugees are being received when they arrive at Poland or many of those other Eastern European countries. Prams being left lined up at train stations in Poland. Thousands of people signing up on Airbnb to offer their homes as accommodation for refugees. People donating generously to help with Ukraine relief efforts. So much being offered in terms of time, money, comfort, accommodation. Why we have to have war, I'll never know. In fact, my best guess is that it's just selfishness, greed. I'm not sure. But where there is suffering, there is also compassion. And right at the moment, the compassion around the world for Ukraine is really quite inspiring. Remembering, of course, that there are also other areas of the world also needing our compassion, our generosity. UNICEF, UNHCR, World Food Programme, Act for Peace, Save the Children, CARE, Red Cross, so many opportunities to donate if you would like. So like so many of you around the world, I watch this unfold astonished and heartbroken, but also full of gratitude for the efforts that are being made. People around the world, especially those Eastern European nations, offering help where they can, giving practical assistance, opening their homes, giving their hand. Thank you for your compassion.